Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and thanks for watching my other videos about how we can install SCCM, SQL database and DP, MP and the other roles. So this video is about how we can install the FSP, fallback status point. So first we'll come to know what is the fallback status point. So when this role is used to receive a status message from client side. Okay guys, so I'm repeating again, this role is used for receiving a status message from the client side, like the client got failed, client unable to communicate. So all kind of status messages will receive through FSP. If FSP is not there, then you're unable to track the status messages. Okay guys, so let's start this video how we can configure this role. So first you click on that administrator, then the site configuration and server and the site role. So this role I will install on the primary site. I will add it role on that same server where the my primary server installed. Okay, so here is the my primary site and I want to add here, I have the DP SS secondary site. So I will add this role on my primary site. So how will I add it? Just right click and add the site role. We can wait till window will open. It's little bit hanging. Okay, so now this window came and the automatically you can see in it's taken SCCM and the site code, because I click on that on the site and I'm adding the role. If I'm creating a new, then we have to fill the all the entries. Okay, so here is no need to do anything. It's like the FQDN for the internet. So this is if you want to install your FSB on the internet. So internet based client is something like where your client is working out of infra and you don't have the VPN connectivity. Okay, so let's click on next. Proxy, I am not using any proxy server because I am in the lab environment. So if you are having any the proxy server to connect the internet, you can specify here the proxy server. Click on next. So here is giving the roles name. What are the roles we can install here? So here is I am selecting the FSP, fallback status point, and let me click next. So here is an option to allow the internet connection. So it's not giving me the other option. We can install as it is, allow the internet connection only. And this is the number of status messages, how many status messages we can receive. After that it will be overwrite. So this is throttling interval in the second, in the how frequently we'll get the message. So it's a 3600 seconds. That means is like 6 hours almost. If you want to change, you can change it like the 1 hour. It's a 1 hour setting. Okay, so 1 hour will be 3600 seconds. So every 1 hour, we'll get the status message. Click on next. So here it's showing the summary. What we have set up it, it will show. If you have not put it, like if you feel something goes wrong, you can click the previous and correct it and then click on next. So click on next now. The progress in done. Okay, so this progress is done and but this role is still it's not installed. We have to check some few logs there. Let me click here and FSP. So this role is added, but how will ensure it's working or it's got installed successfully? Okay, so to be sure that we need some logs. Let me go to the logs folder. D drive, configuration manager, here is the logs. So when we are installing any of site component, we have to use the log site component log. This is a log site comp dot logs. Just open this and we can check whether the roles is getting installed or not. Okay, still it has not started. Let us go to monitoring site status, site component. You can see it here whether this role is came or not. Distribution point, fallback status point. Okay guys, so it's got installed. And here you can see it's a on a green color because there is no much component started with the fallback status point. There is a some other error, we'll look into later on. Okay guys, so this role is installed, and where it got installed we can see the path under the D drive program file configuration manager. Let's check it. D drive program file configuration manager. So where we can find out this role. Let me check first this, what is going on here. Go to stick somewhere. Okay guys, so let us check the logs FSP manager. This logs is created and it's showing it's a thread created and that started successfully. So my fallback status point is started successfully. So now it will work and it's a active also. Let's see the FSP MSI. So two logs is generated when it was installing. And it is installed perfectly. Okay guys, so this role is installed. It's not taking much time because there is a nothing much to see in the FSP, and you can see whether it's working or not. So this is the logs on the site SCCM.once.com fallback status, and if it is showing the green, that means it's working perfectly. Okay guys, so in this video only this much was there for the FSP. It's a very small role, but it's the dependency is very high, and it's used to when you are installing any SCCM client, and it's sending the status messages. To receive the status messages from client side, FSP role is mandatory to install that on SCCM. Okay guys, so thanks for watching this video. See you soon in my next video.